Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Monday, SpaceX successfully launched their 97th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Amazon KF2. The boost which launched this mission, B-1091, then landed successfully for the first time on the drone ship a shortfall of gravitas. On Thursday, SpaceX successfully launched their 98th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 17-4.
One, ignition. And liftoff of Falcon 9. Go SpaceX, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1093, then landed successfully for the fifth time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
Also on Thursday, SpaceX successfully launched their 99th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 1020.
One. Liftoff. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1085, then landed successfully for the 10th time on the drone ship Just Read the Instructions.
Landing leg deploy.
This coming week, we can hopefully expect to see a few launches. The first of these, the Starlink 17-5 mission, is currently scheduled for tomorrow, Monday 18th at 4:44pm UTC or 12:44pm EDT. A few days later and we should see a customer mission launch. The USSF-36 mission is currently scheduled for Friday 22nd at 4:40am UTC or 12:40am EDT. The same day and we should see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 17-6 mission is currently scheduled for Friday 22nd at 4:44pm UTC or 12:44pm EDT. A couple of days after that and we should see a Dragon mission launch. The CRS-33 mission is currently scheduled for Sunday 24th at 7:45am UTC or 3:45am EDT. Heading to Boca Chica, there was some orbital pad 2 tank farm testing recently. Groundwork on the new air separation facility has been continuing. Work continues on the recovered booster 13 aft section with most engines now removed. The work on the foundations for the gigabay are continuing. SpaceX posted some cool pictures of redesigned grid fins for the Super Heavy booster. They said the first grid fin for the next generation Super Heavy booster. The redesigned grid fins are 50% larger and higher strength, moving from 4 fins to 3 for vehicle control while enabling the booster to descend at higher angles of attack. SpaceX also posted some cool renders in response to show how the grid fins would look on the booster and full stack. We finally have a no earlier than date for the launch of Starship Flight 10. SpaceX posted saying the 10th flight test of Starship is preparing to launch as soon as Sunday, August 24th. With Flight 10 coming up in a week, I wanted to share information SpaceX posted about Starship Flight 9's issues. They said the booster relit 12 of the planned 13 engines for its landing burn. Shortly after the burn started, an energetic event was observed near the aft end of the vehicle, followed by loss of telemetry. The most probable cause for the failure at landing burn was higher than predicted forces on the booster structure, specifically on the booster's fuel transfer tube due to the increased angle of attack experiment. For the ship, they also said sensors in the nose cone detected a steady increase in methane levels. This continued until approximately 5 minutes into the burn when pressure began to rapidly decrease in the main fuel tank while pressure simultaneously increased in the nose cone. After engine shutdown, the elevated nose cone pressure combined with planned nose cone venting led to a large amount of attitude error which continued to build up until the vehicle's automatic fault systems disabled nose cone venting. The B-18.1 test tank was recently seen undergoing some testing. Recently, SpaceX rolled Starship 37 back to the launch site. It was also lifted onto the orbital Pad 1 launch mount for testing. Starship 37 then did some testing as they prepare for Flight 10. It was later rolled back to the production site for hopefully the final time before launch. As always, I have to say thanks to both Cesar Garcia and Jack Beyer for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams and other space content. That's it for this episode of The SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.